In this tutorial, we are going to understand Twitter Bootstrap framework content distribution inside column class names. Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this short tutorial, we are going to understand how to make some content distribution inside column class names of Twitter design Bootstrap framework. This is the actual content layout as we have seen from our previous tutorial, but this is the thing that we want to learn, how to create these gaps, how to make gaps inside those columns. And as I have mentioned in our previous tutorial, that in case of making some gaps inside these Bootstrap contents, inside these column contents, we have to pour some contents inside it, and they will be automatically taking a gap of 15 pixels from both sides. Practically, Bootstrap uses the strategy of leaving a padding of 15 pixels from either ends, from the left side and from the right side, and that is why whenever we pour some content inside it, then it automatically realigns itself, leaving a total gap of 30 pixels from both the ends, from left and from the right. But in case if we want to have a display on it, how to create these gaps, as we have seen in this particular case, then all we need to do, we need to make some innovation into it. So the first thing that we are going to do, we are going back to our project here, which is index.html, and we have previously created a custom.css where we have defined some default selectors and we have created some banners. Now inside this index.html, what we can see, we have practically aligned themselves into a single tag, like here div class container banner 1. Inside this div class row appears, and inside this col-lg 4, first of all we have called in the larger column preview, and then we have called in this banner to selector name that we have created here, this one actually. In the same process we have called in another col-lg 4 along with this class name, this selector name, which is known as banner 3, and successively we have created another class name which is known as banner 4. After making this kind of coding over here, when we are previewing our output into our browser, then all we get here is this sort of thing where no gaps are appearing along. But now we are making some certain changes. What we are doing here, we are just copying this class name and we are separating them. Now instead of banner 2, which was appearing along with col-lg 4 that we have created, this col-lg 4 is actually the Bootstrap column class name that we have called in. This 4 indicates that 4 columns will be consumed over here, and we have poured this div class banner 2 inside this div class col-lg 4 here. In the same manner, what we are doing here, we are separating this, there you go, banner 3. In the same manner, first of all, cut the selector name and place it over here. Now if you just press Ctrl+S, save this project and get back to your browser and reload, now you can clearly see that these gaps, those are now appearing in between each contents. As we have seen previously, that all these contents, they were practically aligned together, they were practically utilizing the full width and no gaps were provided there. It was the apparent thing that was practically being viewed by us, but in actuality there was a padding always there. There will be a padding over there. And each time you are pouring some content inside your Bootstrap columns, then all you will be seeing, there will be a 15 pixels of gap from both the ends, as you can see over here. Now, if you do not wish to provide any gap over here, then all you need to do, you need to get back to custom.css. You could create a selector name as, so we have created a class name known as this no padding. That means we are not providing any padding. You may see here that padding left is set to 0 pixels and padding right is set to 0 pixels. Now if you get back to index.html and in this parent div, if you provide this class name as no padding, now just press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and now you can see that the padding that was by default being placed by the Twitter Bootstrap framework, it is now getting vanished. It is now practically leaving no padding from the left or no padding from the right. So this is how you may customize your gapping, and this is how you may modify it. So remember, each time whenever you are putting some contents inside, such as in this case, this is the container, this yellow box, this is practically the container, and inside this container you are practically putting some contents here, but this is not the actual case. In actuality, you have created, you have called in some column, some default column class name such as col-lg4, as you have provided here. You see in this top area, col-lg4, you have created these classes first, and inside these classes, just observe it over here, inside these classes col-lg4, you are creating this banner 3. In case if you want your contents appear as if in this image, as you can see over here. In this particular case, they are practically leaving a total gap of 15 pixels from the extreme left and a total gap of 15 pixels from the extreme right condition. That means they are leaving a padding from both the sides, and in between this red box, it is leaving a gap of 15 pixels from the right, and this green box, it is practically leaving a gap of 15 pixels from its left, and that is why at a total of 30 pixels gap is being provided between this red box and between this green box. So this is what we had to learn from this tutorial. From now on, whenever you are trying to provide some customization, in case if you wish to go by the default values as per prescribed by Twitter Bootstrap, then all you need to do, you need to call in the class names first. This is the default class name that has been assigned into Bootstrap, and then inside this class name you have to call in another div with another selector name, and that is how you will achieve this kind of output. And in case if you want to make some customization, that means in first case there won't be any gap, but from the later on there will be some certain gaps over there. If your project demands such kind of allocation, then all you need to do, you have to create another no padding selector name, and then you have to get back to index.html, and inside this parent name, such as over here, inside this parent class name, you have to put it all along together. If you just create another div over here, for say you are creating another div, for say you have named it as learning, this is as an example. In this particular case too, there will be another 15 pixels of gaps from both the ends. It will practically generate a padding from both the ends, from left and right, and total of 30 pixels gap will be left from both the ends equally distributed. That means 15 pixels from the left and 15 pixels from the right, and so on. And this process will continue each time whenever you are creating some classes over here. Hope you have liked this tutorial. If you have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit the red subscribe button. Subscribe us to stay tuned for more. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.